Welcome back to DT Daily. I'm Casey Montoya. Big news in the tech world today. Yahoo is suing Facebook over patent infringement. Intel has announced internet TV ambitions. A homeless hotspots campaign caused quite a stir at South by Southwest. Twitter bought short-form blog Pastorus, and scientists vow to bring back the woolly mammoth. Struggling internet giant Yahoo flexed its muscles Monday, filing a lawsuit against Facebook for allegedly infringing on 10 of its patents. The aggressive revenue-boosting strategy, reportedly concocted by new Yahoo CEO Scott Thompson, comes at a vulnerable time for Facebook, which is currently in a mandatory quiet period prior to its initial public offering. Facebook has vowed to fight the suit full force. In a puzzling report today, the Wall Street Journal claims that Intel, a company known exclusively for selling processors and computer chips, is developing a pay TV service. Using a set-box top, the new service would offer a bundle of U.S. TV channels over the internet for a cheaper price than customers pay for traditional cable TV. The new strategy is part of Intel CEO Paul Otellini's to vow to diversify Intel's business. A pay TV service will be difficult, however. Apple, Google, and a number of other companies have tried to break cable TV companies' tight control over television channels, but doing so could cause those companies, which also control how much of the country's internet access, to raise rates for customers. A charitable experiment called Homeless Hotspots has riddled this year's South by Southwest Interactive Festival with controversy. Launched and funded by marketing firm BBH Labs, Homeless Hotspots equips homeless people in Austin with 4G LTE MiFi devices. South by attendees can give a donation, which the homeless person keeps to use the mobile internet connection. While BBH Labs and others defend Homeless Hotspots program as an innovative way to help those in need, critics argue that requiring participants to wear a t-shirt that reads, "I am a 4G hotspot," is degrading and dehumanizing. Twitter continues its buying streak today. The social network has purchased Pastorus, a service that lets you post once and feeds that post to all of your social networks and blogs. In the announcement, Pastorus claims that the service will remain up and running, but hinted that it might shut down at a future date. The purchase is only the latest for Twitter, which recently bought companies like TweetDeck, Backtype, and Nasian. It appears the purchase was for talent, not for the Pastorus platform. Twitter welcomed employees into its team and said they'll be working on key initiatives to make the social network even better. South Korean scientists are joining the mission to clone a woolly mammoth. Hwang Woo-suk and Vasily Vasiliev will join Japanese and Russian scientists to bring a mammoth back to life. The team plans to restore the cells of a mammoth carcass found frozen in Siberia. They would bring the mammoth to life by using cells and womb of a modern-day Indian elephant. Hwang Woo-suk has a long history in cloning. Last October, he unveiled 8 cloned coyotes. That's it for today. Make sure to check back on Digital Trends later today for a closer look at Intel's new internet TV service and a full review of HP's TouchSmart 520 all-in-one desktop PC.